Hi friends, this is Grace and welcome to process video number 181 entitled Gather the Ones You Love. This is my third layout assignment for the Scrap Broom Kit Club, and this features one of the mini collections from the April Flavors of the Month kit, and it features the Flower Market collection from Cartabella, and I'm just showing you all of the products that came with it. I will be adding a few things from the embellishment add-on kit, which is that chipboard, and this is also my assignment for the Freaky Fast Friday challenge for this month. So with the Freaky Fast Friday, if you're new to it, basically you get some specific cuts of papers, and you are to cut the papers to the specific for the right specifications, and then you are to basically make your layout using just those specifications. And so this one had I had a little bit of a hard time with this because first of all, it had a big like 10-inch circle or something that I can't quite remember. But it had a big circle and then a few little pieces and two strips. So the big circle was the one that I had the hardest time with, because I have 4 3x5 or like 3.5x5.5 piece and of photos, I mean, and so it's hard to have a circle where you're gonna end up covering it most of it up. So yeah, so you can see I'm tapping my fingers because I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to work this out. And I ended up actually cutting up the circle because it was just too big and I wanted to kind of show most of it without covering it up with my photos. And I'm sorry that my son was kind of in the way. He was showing me, he rediscovered the cabinet that we have underneath our entertainment center that had a bunch of DVDs, and so he was showing me all the DVDs that he was kind of discovering or finding in the cabinet. So I thought that was kind of cute. And then it also, the specific formula for the Freaky Fast also came with two smaller cuts of paper. I can't remember exactly what it was. Maybe it was like a one was like a 3x5 and a 4x6 or something like that. So these are the cuts, and then that's what I have to work on. So I'm going to figure out, see, as you can see, that was my initial thought, was just laid on the center, but it covers the circle up. So I needed to kind of move things around, and luckily some of these photos could be cropped without taking away too much from the photos. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna lay three of them on the top, and then the bottom will house this one photo. And just trying to figure out how I'm gonna arrange my papers. And as you can see, the circle is on the bottom and that will remain there. But I felt like I cut up all those papers and like a third of it is not even showing. So I'm going to cut that up and kind of move the smaller part of the circle on the top. And so basically that's going to be my page. I'm still trying to figure out what I'm going to do, and I've decided to ink up the edges with some distress ink pad. I forgot what the specific one, not Storm maybe, but it's kind of a grayish color, and so I'm going to ink up all of the edges of the pattern paper. And here, that this is when I've decided to cut a little piece of that just to kind of make that show, and I like how that looks, and so I'm going to ink up the edges and commit to that, and ink up the rest of the edges of the pattern papers, and then go from there. Now a little bit about the photos. These are photos from 2014, so I know it's kind of late, or it's been a while, that's like 5 years ago, but you know, I never scrap chronologically, so I just scrap whenever I have pictures or what I want to document. So, and it's totally fine with me. I feel like if I have the if I ever get caught up, then I won't have anything to scrap. So I'm not very concerned about the timeline of like which things I need to scrap. Of course, if I scrap the ones that are older, then I will be able to at least remember, or some of the things are still fresh in my mind, because as days and years go by, I forget, but for the most part, I do not scrapbook chronologically. So I also wanted this photo to kind of be my focal photo, and it needed to stand out against the papers. And I knew as far as like my design is concerned, that parts of that cardstock background will not show, will be covered with pattern paper. So I decided to mat my photos with the background cardstock so that it will all match. And then I knew that I was going to cover that part anyway, so it won't show in the front. Okay, so now that I've adhered my photos and my papers, now I'm going to work on the title. Now this gather chipboard piece came from the chipboard sheet from the embellishment add-on kit, and I like the word gather because it's big enough, it can, you know, lead your eye to the title. But I was trying to figure out what kind of title to go with the gather word, and then I found this one sticker sheet from that same chipboard pack that said gather the ones you love. And so I felt like that would be perfect. And so I actually went to my scraps of my, oh, not scraps, but my stash of little word stickers, and so, or letter stickers, I should say. And then I spelled out the ones you love for with using just a small letter sticker from, I believe that's Basic Gray. Now the chipboard, for some reason, it wasn't adhering very well with just the sticky back of it from the packaging, and so I decided to spray it with my liquids or my spray adhesive and then put that back on there because it just wasn't sticking very well. And then so that's gonna be my title, and I will also type up my journaling, which I will cut into strips and then add it to the bottom of the title. And now it's time to decorate, and this is one of my favorite parts of actually working with a layout, is once everything is set, then I could just play with the embellishments. So basically I'm gonna use this 12 by 12 sticker sheet and pretty much go to town with embellishments. I will also add a border. Yes, I will add a border, and I'm trying to think what else I add. And yes, just a bunch of hearts and stickers. Some of them I will add with some foam adhesive to give it a dimension, and then the others I will just add as, you know, just a single or just a flat sticker. So the photos are of me and my family. We kind of have this tradition that we go to California during the summertime because that's where both our parent, my husband and I's parents live. And then just before we leave, just before we start our road trip back home to Colorado, we kind of stop by my parents' house, and because we stay at my husband's parents' house, we stop by their house and we take pictures, and it just seems like that's kind of like a tradition. And so I documented how that seems to be a tradition that we do right before we leave town. We take pictures, and it just so happens that at this particular visit this summer, my sister was also visiting from the East Coast, and so we took pictures of them and all the cousins, and that was really good. And that fit perfectly with the title, Gather the Ones You Love. And basically, that's going to be my layout. If you have any questions, make sure that you leave it in the comment section below. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing. I do have different kinds of playlists on my channel, so make sure that you check that out. And I will catch you guys another day. Bye.